The tab toolbar is located at the top of the application window. It contains almost all the tools for creating and editing content. The tools can be put together in a tab or group like this. A group consists of some commands. Each has its own label. The tab toolbar can be customized easily in ActivePresenter. To do that, open the Preferences dialog. Then, open the Toolbar tab. Here, you can see the Choose Commands from box on the left and the Customize Toolbar box on the right. The tabs, groups, and commands are hierarchized as being shown on the screen in the box and shown in the current toolbar. Next, you will learn how to work with the tab toolbar in this video. In detail, you can create custom tabs and groups, customize tabs, groups and commands, and restore defaults. Depending on your work style, you can create custom tabs or groups of your own. To create a new tab, click this button. Then, name the new tab in the name dialog. Click OK, then the new tab is inserted below all other tabs or under the selected tab. In order to create a new group, select the tab you want to add the group into. Then click the New Group button and name the newly inserted group. Do it again if you need more groups. The newly created tab and groups are marked with a custom label. This is to distinguish them from the default ones. The default and custom tabs, groups, and commands can be reordered, added, renamed, and removed. To reorder a tab, select it, then use the up or down blue arrows here. To customize the toolbar, you can also add more tabs, groups to a tab, or commands to the groups. To add a new tab, select the tab you want to add on the left, and a tab on the right. Then click the Add button. The newly added tab contains the groups and commands as the original one. Now you can add any groups into the custom tabs, or the default ones. Firstly, select one that you want to insert a group into. Then, select the group in the left box and click the Add button. Repeat the steps if needed. Besides, commands can be inserted into a group, but only into the custom groups. Therefore, before adding commands, you need to create or select a custom group. Then, select the command in the left box and click the Add button. Keep doing that until it meets your needs. Note that you can choose to show or hide the commands label inside a custom group. They are shown by default and hidden if you tick the Hide Command Labels checkbox. Another way to customize the tab toolbar is renaming tabs and groups in the right box. You can rename any of those, both the default and custom one, by selecting them and clicking the Rename button. Type the new name and click OK. For commands, only the custom ones in the custom group can be renamed. Last but not least, all the tabs and groups in the right box can be removed easily. You can do that by simply unticking the checkbox next to each of them. Another way to remove the default and custom groups is selecting one, then clicking the Remove button. You can remove the custom command as well. One thing to keep in mind is the contextual tabs like Slide Master cannot be removed. Now, let's check the newly customized toolbar. You can see there is no Home tab. The Insert tab's name is changed to Import. It consists of fewer groups and commands than the original. The Custom tab Favorite consists of the custom groups and commands. Some of the commands labels are hidden. In case you want a larger space to preview or edit your project, you can hide the tab toolbar by double-clicking any tab or clicking the double arrow button here. If you need to go back to all original settings, the Restore Defaults button is here to help. Then, the tab toolbar only shows the defaults. That's the way to work with the tab toolbar. Thanks for watching.